What did you do after high school?
I came here to the island at the University of Victoria, and I started school here.
We're sailing today aboard the Pacific Grace. It's actually a copy of one of the boats that SALTS originally started with. The boat's name was the Robertson II. It was an original fishing schooner from the east coast of Canada. And when it got too tired to carry on in the program, SALTS decided to replace it. And they built a copy of that Robertson II and named it Pacific Grace. Thank you.
Alright.
Sailing before anchoring in Russell.
All of your questions about where you want to go next and what you want your learning to do. So take a look at your natural environment. Now some of you have already been able to come up with your questions. Some of you are interested, you're curious. You're giving me a little bit of those glacier moments where I'm losing my mind looking at stuff. So can we take the next 2 minutes or so, look around and make a question. Something about what you want to learn about. Ask a question and then we're going to actually record what the questions are to see if we can take them back to the classroom.
Before we were talking about rocks, we know grooves. What is the last set of grooves that we saw were created by a what?
Erosion. Glacier.
Yeah, so we have the plucking and abrading from glacial rock. When we take a look at the west coastline, Do we see striations here?
No, we don't.
No, right? Because how do we know these aren't striations?
They're not all uniform.
Mm-hmm. And because they're not like scratches, right? We don't see the scratches at Alex, exactly. So if it's not glacial striations, what is it?
Would it be wind
erosion? Mm-hmm. So it could be a little bit of wind. It's mostly tidal though, right? It's water erosion.
I want to know what they eat, what eats them, and what triggers them to close. Because when you put your finger in it, it just closes on you.
And then the rocks will come in and act like attrition, and they'll actually come in and carve it out. So all of any sort of little material in the rock, yeah.
So any little purchase it can make will slowly build one of those out.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. And then it acts like this. So this ridge could eventually get deeper and deeper, and this will just keep carving, carving, carving. And you can tell this rock is different.
So like, over time, heat and pressure turns the sand, gets compressed into stone.
Come on! But why is it so cranky?
Because of the layers being like rocks.
Does the salinity of the water affect erosion?
I'd like to know how long it takes for sand rock to form.
I would like to know where oak trees grow.
I'd like to know how there's two different stones and one giant stone.
I want to know why sandstone dimples around hermit crabs.
I'd like to know if there are only certain rocks that, I don't remember what they're called, connect to.
What's the relationship between the fungus and the tree?
Why are starfish different colors?
How rocks get trapped in other rocks.
I'd like to know why there's a hole there.
I'd like to know what type of rocks form on the ocean.
I want to know how long it takes for a fossil to form.
I want to know what gives the tree the red effect.
Are we harming the sea life by taking it out of the water?
The red trees on these islands relate to eucalyptus trees.
I see anemones work.
I just want to know more about crabs in general.
How cold is the ocean water?
I want to better understand how sandstone forms in layers, the process behind it, and then if it's similar with other structural building materials like concrete.
I want to know why arbutus trees shed their bark in that manner.
I want to know how many different species there are in the ocean, because turning that corner we found like 15.
I
want to
know what different species of starfish are all around us.
Why are the trees red?
Why are the trees stripping their own bark?
I want to know, I learned from Carbid that limpets have some of the strongest structural material in the world, natural world and human-made world. So why is it stronger than Kevlar?
And I want to know if this makes learning better. Into the dark,
found by. Sit for a little while. You'll see the lip on it will open up. So the shell will open up. You can see the lip on it. And there's actually little eyes on it that it sees from.
Goodbye, Mr. Dab.
I was still running. Eyes closed and feel the sun rays on your skin.
They're that good, like they are.
These look like tiny umbrellas.
I went. Cut to the father side and stole. I was still fighting for all that you deserve. Although it seems likely that I left before the storm, the truth is I couldn't leave you wanting more. I trust my life. Thank you.
Have a tears character.